Welkom to part 2 of my how to crochet a seahorse video. In part 1 I'm showing the body and now I'm showing all other parts. And the link to part 1 is in the description of this video. Now I'm going to make the snout now. I'm going to start with a magic wing again. Wrap the yarn around your finger twice, go into those two loops with your crochet hook, grab the yarn, pull it through. Grab the yarn again and pull it through the loop on your crochet hook. This is the magic wing. And this is the first single crochet. I'm going to make another single crochet. 3, 4, 5, and 6. Now I'm going to close the magic wing by pulling a small piece of yarn. One loop will become smaller. I'm going to pull on the bottom side of that smaller becoming loop to close the other one completely. And then pull on a small piece of yarn again to close the magic wing. And then we can start with the second round. First I'm going to take some leftover yarn to mark the beginning of the round. And now we're going to start with round 2. In round 2 we're going to make one single crochet in the first stitch. And in every second stitch we're going to make an increase. So in this first stitch, one single crochet. And in the second stitch, two single crochets in the same stitch. And every first, one single crochet. And in every second, two single crochets in the same stitch. An increase. In the first stitch, one single crochet. And every second, an increase. Two single crochets in the same stitch. And then I'm going to place the marker yarn. And start on round 3. Round 3 and 4 are really easy. Just make one single crochet in every stitch of the round. So do this for 2 rounds. Round 3 and 4. In round 5, I'm going to make one single crochet in the first stitch and every second and third, I'm going to crochet together. So in this first stitch, I'm going to make one single crochet. And now I'm going to crochet every second and third stitch together, a decrease. I'm going to repeat this until the end of the round. So again, in the first stitch, one single crochet. And then crochet the next 2 stitches together. I have to do this one more time. In the first stitch, one single crochet. And then crochet the last 2 stitches together. A decrease. And now I'm done with the snout. I just have to fasten off with a slip stitch. Going to do this by going to the next stitch with my crochet hook. I'm going to grab the yarn and pull it through the stitch, but and then also immediately to the loop on my crochet hook. This is called a slip stitch. Now I can cut the yarn and pull it through. Now I'm going to use the yarn that's sticking out of the magic wing to pull the front side inside the snout. If your magic wing yarn is not long enough, then you can use sew in another piece of yarn and use that to pull the front side into the snout. And now I can sew it on the body. First I'm going to use a pin to sew the snout on the body. to place the snout on the body. We're going to sew the snout on rounds 9 and 10 between the eyes. Then we're going to use a pin to put it in place. And I will show you exactly how to sew the snout on the body. First I'm going to sew in the yarn that's sticking out of the snout. I'm going to hide it under the snout. And now I just have to hide the remaining yarn in the body. And now I'm going to sew the last round of the snout onto the body. On rounds 9 and 10. And now I just have to hide the remaining yarn inside the body. I can cut off the yarn and then we're going to start making part of the mane. I'm going to start with a magic ring. Wrap the yarn twice around your finger. Go into those loops. Grab the yarn with your crochet hook. Grab the yarn again. Now we made a magic ring. We're going to single crochet 4 times into the magic ring. This is the second single crochet. This is the third single crochet. And the fourth single crochet. Now close the magic ring. We're going to pull the small piece of yarn. One loop becomes smaller. Pull on the smaller becoming loop to close the other one completely. And then pull on the small piece of yarn again to close the magic ring. And now I'm going to place a piece of marker yarn and start on round 2. In round 2 we're going to make 1 single crochet in every first stitch and in every second an increase. So in this first stitch I'm going to make 1 single crochet. And in the second stitch an increase, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And then again in the first stitch 1 single crochet and in the second stitch 2 single crochets in the same stitch. This is a bit small, so I'm going to make sure that the outside, the side that's facing me, is still on the outside. The white side is on the outside. And now I'm going to make an increase in the last stitch. And I'm going to move the marker yarn. And I'm going to fasten over the slip stitch. So in the next stitch make a slip stitch. Then I can cut the yarn and pull it through. And you have to make 4 more. And you can also cut off the yarn that's sticking out of the magic ring. Don't make it too short because the It can fall apart if you cut it off too short. And to sew it on the body, we have to flatten it like this. This is how we're going to sew it on the body. So you have to make 3 more, 4 in total. So I'm going to start sewing through the whole last round. And now I'm going to sew it on the body. First on the front, over round 2 and 3 and 4. So pin it in place in the middle. And then I will show you how to sew it on the body. And now I just have to hide the remaining yarn inside the main. Now I'm going to sew the next part over rounds 1, 2 and 3. I'm going to place a pin here, so I know what exactly what the middle is of the back side of the body. It's easier to see where I have to place the second part. Then I'm going to pin it in place and show you exactly how to sew it on the body. Now I'm going to sew the third part on the body with one round between all of the mains. I'm going to sew it over round 5, 6 and 7. I'm going to sew the last part over round 9, 10 and 11. Going to make the dorsal fin. Start with a magic wing again. And this time we're going to single crochet 6 times into the magic wing. Now this is the first single crochet. The second single crochet. The third single crochet. 4, 5, and 6. Now you have to close the magic ring, pull a small piece of yarn, one loop becomes smaller. And then pull on the bottom side of the smaller becoming loop to close the other one completely. And then pull a small piece of yarn again. And now we're going to start on the second round. First place a piece of marker yarn, leftover yarn. So you know where the start of your round is. In the next round we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first stitch. And every second stitch an increase. So in this first stitch, 1 single crochet. And in the second stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And we're going to repeat this until the end of the round. So in every first stitch, 1 single crochet. And in every second, an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And we have to do that one more time. In the first stitch, 1 single crochet. And the second, 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And now we're going to start with round 3. First place the marker yarn. And in round 3 we're going to make 1 single crochet in the first 2 stitches. And every third an increase. So in this first stitch 1 single crochet. And in the second also 1 single crochet. And in every third an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. And you have to repeat this 2 more times. And every first 2 stitches, 1 single crochet. And every third an increase. 2 single crochets in the same stitch. One more time, 1 single crochet in the next stitch. And also in the second stitch, 1 single crochet. In the last stitch, 2 single crochets in the same stitch, an increase. We are almost done with the dorsal fin. This is the last round. We just have to fasten over the slip stitch. Going to make a slip stitch into the next stitch. And then you can cut the yarn and pull it through. And you can also remove the marker yarn because we don't need it anymore. And we also have to flatten the dorsal fin. Just gonna cut off the yarn from the magic ring. And now I'm going to sew the last round together. So first flatten it and then sew to the flattened fin. Now I'm going to sew to the fin, to the front side of the first round of the fin. Because we're going to sew the first round onto the body. We're going to sew the dorsal fin between rounds 17 and 18. And first I'm going to pin it in place. And I will show you exactly how to sew the fin on the body. Between rounds 17 and 18. And now the little seahorse is done. I hope you enjoyed creating this little seahorse amigurumi. If you did, please don't forget to like the video and subscribe to my YouTube channel. That would be really great. And if you like making sea animals, I have many more patterns on my YouTube channel and on my website, my blog. And the links are all in the description of this video. I also made many more patterns that are available on my Etsy shop. And I also made a book for beginners, especially for beginners, which is available on Amazon, Amigurumi Made Easy. And thank you for watching my video.